Hello and welcome to Tech School. In this backend masterclass, we're going to learn everything about how to design, develop, and deploy a complete backend system from scratch using PostgreSQL, Golang, and Docker. The service that we are going to build is a simple bank. It will provide APIs for the frontend to do following things. First, create and manage bank accounts, which are composed of owner's name, balance, and currency. Second, record all balance changes to each of the account. So every time some money is added to or subtracted from the account, an account entry record will be created. And third, perform a money transfer between two accounts. This should happen within a transaction so that either both accounts' balance are updated successfully or none of them are. In the first lecture, we will learn about database design. I will show you how to design a SQL database schema using dbdiagram.io, then save the schema as a PDF or PNG diagram to share it with your team, and finally generate SQL code to create the schema in the target database engine of your choice, such as PostgreSQL, MySQL, or SQL Server. Okay, let's start by going to dbdiagram.io and click Go to App. This is a sample DB schema. On the left, we define the table structure with some simple syntax. Then its corresponding diagram will show up on the right. We can use the export tool at the top to save this diagram as a PDF or PNG file or generate SQL code for Postgres, MySQL, or SQL Server. Alright, now let's modify this schema for our database. I'm going to change the name of this diagram to Simple Bank. Okay, first we will have an account table. We use a table keyword to declare a table and use a S keyword to set a short alias name for it. Let's say we want each account to have a unique ID, so I'm going to use an auto increment ID field for it. In this sample script, they use the increment keyword for that purpose. But in Postgres, we could also use a type big serial. It basically means a big auto-incrementing integers, 8-byte or 64-bit. We use a pk keyword to say that this field is the primary key of this table. The next field is owner, which stores the name of the account owner. So its type can be text or varchar. Then a balance field to store the amount of available money of the account. To be simple, I just use begin type here. In reality, some currencies are not always integers, so you should consider using something like decimal type instead. Now let's add one more field to store the name of the currency. And finally, a created at field to know when the account is created. I think we should use a timestamp TZ type here instead of just timestamp, because it includes the time zone information as well. And we want it to be automatically set by the database, so let's set a default value for it with a default keyword. Postgres has a now function to get the current time. We can simply put it inside a backtick pair to use it as a default value. And that's it. The account table is done. The next table is entries. This table will record all changes to the account balance. It also has an auto increment ID column, which is a primary key. And it has a forEach key, account ID of type begint, that references the ID column of the account table. As you might know, this represents one-to-many relationship between account and entries table, because one account can have many entries to change its balance. Another field we will need is the amount of money that is added to the account balance in this entry. It can be positive or negative, depending on whether the money is going into or out of the account. And finally, a created at field to record when the entry is created. The last table is transfers. It records all the money transfers between two accounts. Let's say in this course, we just care about internal transfer within Simple Bank. So this table will have an auto increment ID primary key, a foreign key from account ID, and another foreign key to account ID. Both reference the ID column of the account table. Then the amount of money that moves from one account to the other. But unlike amount in the entries table, this amount value must be positive. And finally, the created at field, just like in other tables. Okay, our DB schema is almost done. Now let's look at the rest of the example to see if there's anything we can add. This is another way to declare the foreign key reference. And we can also add some not null or unique constraint to some fields in our tables like this. I don't think we have any fields that should be unique, except for the primary keys, which already are. So I'm gonna add not null constraint to the owner, balance, currency, and created at column of account table. The amount and created at columns of entries table. And similar for the transfers table. We can also add some note to the columns. So let's add a note to the amount column of entries table, saying it can be negative or positive. And another note to the amount column of transfers table, saying it must be positive. We can even define a custom enum type for our column. For example, we can define a currency enum with two possible values, USD and Euro, and use it at the type of the account currency column. However, I prefer to use built-in type varchar here and let the application code handle the value validation. Okay, the last thing we need to do is to add indexes to our tables. For that, we will use the indexes keyword. In the account table, we might want to search for account by owner name. So let's add owner to the list of the indexes. In the entries table, we might want to list all entries of a specific account. So let's add account ID to the index. The transfers table is the most complex. We might want to search for all transfers that are going out of an account. So from account ID should be one index. Similarly, we might want to look for all transfers that are going into an account. So to account ID should be another index. And finally, if we want to search for all transfers between two specific accounts, then we need a composite index of both from account ID and to account ID. And that's it. Our schema definition is completed. Now on the right, we can click Auto Arrange to reorganize the DB diagram that has been automatically generated for us. It looks very nice, but let me rearrange it a bit so that we can see the relationship links more clearly. Okay, as you can see, there's a one-to-many links from account to entries table, and there are two one-to-many links from account to transfers table. Now let's try to generate PostgreSQL code by using the export tool at the top of the page. The file is downloaded. Let's open it. Yeah, we have beautiful code ready to be ran in PostgreSQL to create the database schema. There are three create table queries to create the account, entries, and transfers table. Then three auto table queries to add foreign keys to the tables. Then five create index queries to create all the indexes. And finally, two comment queries to add the comment to the amount columns. Now let's try to export the diagram to PDF file. Here we go. The diagram is successfully saved as a PDF file, ready to be shared with the team. You can also export to other formats as well. For example, this is a generated MySQL code. Alright, the last thing we need to do is to save this design and click Share to get the link to share it with others, or use the embedded link to embed it into other pages. And that's everything I want to share with you in this first lecture of the course. I hope it's useful for you. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.